What's up, guys? In this video, we're going to break down how to maximize your success with night game. And yes, contrary to popular belief, I do occasionally venture outside the Tinder world to interact with chicks in real life. So I'm going to share my personal strategy, some tips and tricks that I picked up along the way, and an example of a real life interaction of a number that I got at a bar from start to finish, so you guys can get a real good idea of how exactly to text those cold approach numbers. Right, so night game starts before you even leave your place. So first thing you want to do is make sure you dress well, right? You don't have to go crazy and dress super fancy. You just want to wear, you know, clothes that fit well. Just follow the rules of good fashion. I mean, I think this is outside the scope of this video, but you can follow guys like Alpha M on YouTube and just other people who really have more fashion sense than me. But you do want to dress somewhat well because that's where really the game begins. Also, make sure you wear cologne and then you smell good. Like, you know, if you go out to a bar, like one out of three guys are just going to smell like shit. So they're already shooting themselves in the foot before they even approach. Next is, okay, what kind of places do you want to go? Now, a lot of guys make the mistake of going to crazy clubs or raves and think that those are the best place to meet girls. They're not. Really, the best places for night game are chill bars and lounges. You want to go to places where the music is not too loud and you can talk. And the bigger the venue, the better. So in Miami, there's this place called The Wharf, right? It holds maybe 300, 400 people. There's like a big outdoor area. There's a little bit of a bar inside. You know, there's a lot of people there. There's a good ratio. You can talk and have a conversation. That place is going to be much better than, you know, those big hot clubs in Miami. Again, because, you know, first of all, you don't have to pay to get in. Second of all, the ratio is going to be better. Third of all, the girls that go there are actually more interested in meeting someone rather than just, you know, fucking around on Instagram or just getting validation. So really, it's important to pick the right venue. And also, you can have a good time, depends on your city, just by walking around the street, you know, at a certain time. For example, in Miami, between 8 and 12, just walking around the street where I live, you can meet just as many girls as you could at any bar or any other venue. Next thing is, when you're actually at the bar, look for IOIs. So you don't want to be just, you know, on your phone or just super distracted, right? Like, pay attention to the environment. Because when a girl is looking at you, we call that a warm approach. And those are way, way more likely to go well than a cold approach, right? So just pay attention. Look for girls that are looking at you. And girls won't be staring at you for too long. I mean, maybe a few will, but most won't. You'll just be something very quick. Like, you'll just catch her. Just constantly just kind of be scanning the environment. And any girl who makes eye contact with you and holds it for like a second, that's going to be much more likely to go well. So look for things like that. And this is something that personally, when I started doing this, my results increased a lot. I was definitely very late to this game. Like, I didn't really start paying attention to this, but, you know, I had Nitin, Indian PE, when we would go out, he'd point out, like, dude, that girl was fucking staring at you. I was like, really? Like, I wasn't even looking, right? So it's important to actually be paying attention. Next is, let's say you're at a bar, no one's really looking at you. Okay, who should you approach? So this is kind of the priority that you want to have. First, look for girls who are by themselves. Those are the most likely to go well. Like, if you see a chick and she's out by herself, that means most of the time that she wants to get laid, right? So those are going to be, you know, the most likely to go well. However, you know, it's really rare that you're going to see a girl by herself. It definitely happens. You definitely want to look for it. But, you know, like, if you don't see it, the next best thing is going to be small, you know, girl sets, right? So when it's two girls or three girls, right? So those are going to be much better than a group of 10 girls. So you generally want to look for, then, if you don't see a girl by herself, girls who are in small groups. After that, you're going to get into like mixed sets and larger groups. Again, you shouldn't be afraid to approach any type of dynamic. Like, you know, I can tell you that my last girlfriend, you know, I met her at a bar and she was with like 10 people, five of them were guys. And, you know, I just confidently approached, pulled her aside, blah, blah, blah. So again, in situations like that, you don't want to be afraid. However, it is also good to prioritize in your mind. It's all about maximizing your success, doing everything you can do to optimize your strategy. Okay, you see a cute girl, maybe she's by herself, maybe she's with a group. How do you approach her? So this is going to be the most effective method. Just go in semi-direct. So an opener I always use is, hi, I'm Alex, while keeping strong eye contact, right? You don't need to say, oh, you know, you're so cute, I want to meet you, blah, blah, blah. You don't really have to do that at a bar. You don't really need to give her a reason. Just because you being there and you talking to her and you having good body language basically communicates the fact that you find her attractive. With day games, sometimes when you stop a girl, you do have to be like, hey, I thought you were cute and I want to meet you real quick. You don't really need to do that for night game. Also, another thing you can do, and this works probably even better if you can do it right, is a situational opener. So this will be something like, you know, a chick's holding a fruity drink, be like, oh, that's my favorite favorite drink. What is that, like fucking Sex and the City times 10? She's like, haha, no, blah, blah, blah. You know, just something situational and contextual like that. But if not, you can just literally go up to a girl and say hi and then insert your name. Don't say Alex if you're not actually Alex. Or you can try it, I don't know. So the next big thing is having strong eye contact and body language. This is equally, if not more important than what you say. Like, you wanna just stare the girl right in the eye, show good and just square up, right? Like, good body language. Don't be like this, just take up space. If the girl is sitting, then it's very important that you sit as well, right? So if you're sitting and the girl is standing, that's actually pretty good, but you don't want to be the one that's standing when she's sitting. So really, again, like, this is something that guys overlook, but this is really, really important if you want to maximize your success. Okay, you have good eye contact, you approach the girl, you have good body language. What the fuck do you talk about? So here I want to explain something called different frames. So there's the I frame where you're like, oh, you know, I do this, I work in accounting, blah, 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 we talk about yourself. This is what the vast majority of guys who approach the girl are doing. This is the worst frame to be in. The second best is the you frame. So it's like, oh, what do you do for fun? Or what do you do for work? It's better, but it's still not optimal. The best frame is the we frame. So where you talk about both of you guys as one unit. So you might say something like, wow, look at us. We're just fucking hitting it off at this bar. We're gonna be like the fucking success story this bar is gonna use on their Instagram page. So yeah, I'm not saying you have to say that, but that's the we frame where you're talking about you guys together. And that's a lot more interesting, entertaining to the girl. So basically my interactions will be a combination, I would say 30, 40%, no, maybe 50% we frame, 40% you frame, and 10% I frame. Like, at the end of the interaction, like, if the cop was to go up to the girl and be like, hey, this guy's actually wanted for being too fucking awesome and having this crazy channel called Playing With Fire where it's like so fucking cool, but it's illegal, you know, what can you tell us about him? She wouldn't really be able to tell the cop much. She'd be like, he cracked a lot of jokes, he had a husky, he touched me, you know, on my ass. Like, she wouldn't really be able to tell specific things. And that's kind of, you know, I'm not saying that when a girl asks you, what do? You should avoid the question. But generally, I'm talking about her and I'm using the we frame. I'm not using the I frame that much. And just that in of itself will make you stand out by a lot. Because again, most guys are just droning on and on about themselves. And no one fucking gives a shit, especially the joke. Especially the girl. The next big thing is just to have fun, flirt, and joke around. Don't take the whole thing too seriously. Like, I just crack a lot of jokes, and if the girl doesn't find my joke funny, that's okay. I don't give a shit. There's a lot of other girls that you can talk to. So I try to be as unfiltered as possible. You know, so basically, you know, what most of us, when we're socializing, we have this filter and this subconscious side that comes in. It's like, oh, you shouldn't say that. Don't do that. I try to turn that off. And, you know, with practice, it gets easier and easier, where now I just kind of just express myself and say what's on my mind. And really, these interactions, they don't need to be crazy long. Like, really, like, the vast majority of my night game interactions are between 5 and 15 minutes. Like, it can really be simple and straightforward. You don't need to be talking to the girl for an hour. And I wouldn't even say that an hour interaction is necessarily going to be that much more solid than a 5-minute interaction. So really, again, you can go up, talk to a few girls, get a few numbers. You can, in an hour, you can, you know, get a lot of results. You don't need to be, you know, stuck on one set for ages. One important thing to keep in mind is that most of your results will come from numbers, right? So yes, same night lays, they happen, they're awesome. Yes, they're a good story. That's not gonna be the majority of your results. It's just not realistic. So, you know, a lot of guys have this, you know, mindset where it's like, oh, I'm gonna push for the same night lay, I'm gonna push for the same night lay. And if it doesn't work out, which it often doesn't, simply because the logistics aren't good, they give up. No, like, my first go-to is actually to get the phone number. And if I sense that, you know, her logistics are really good, she's super into me, and there's a good chance of a same night lay, then I will go for that. But really, I don't make that my default. I think that most of the time, I'm just gonna go for the phone number, I'm gonna set up a date over text, you know, also I'm gonna, you know, set a strong sexual frame in person, and then, you know, most of the time, I'm gonna be able to get her to honestly, at least 50% of the time to come straight to my place. So that's another important thing to keep in mind. And last component is to run good text game, and we're gonna get into it by going through an example. All right, next, let's get into a specific example. I want to use a very recent one so you guys can really see how easy and straightforward this whole thing can be. So this is what I do. When I get a girl's number, I just text her my name. Simple as that. I don't use overly fancy, overly gamey openers because that shit will most likely work against you. So just your name with a winky face is really all you need to say. And then I wait. I let her respond, which most of the time the girl does if I did a semi-decent job talking to her. So she says, mucho gusto, Alex. And notice how she doesn't respond until the very next day. So if I had been impatient, double texted, that would have lost me some points. So here I say, how's my favorite Pennsylvania girl? So this is something I commonly do. You call this callback humor or callback references. So in real life, you know, she told me she was from Pennsylvania. So here I make a little bit of a joke out of it. How's my favorite Pennsylvania girl? She says, I'm doing good. Sorry, I've been distracted all day with life. Haha. How about yourself? And here, really, all I do is use a standard DHV pic that I have on my phone. I send her a picture of me fondling Rhaegar and say, good, just hanging out with this guy. She says, daw, what a sweetie. I'm eating Cajun boil with my girl, keeping it casual tonight. Your roommate told me that was his dog, by the way. So what she's referencing to is my roommate got to the bar way before him, and I let him take Rhaegar. And I guess he approached that same chick claiming Rhaegar. So this is easy. Like, some guys might freak out here and try to give an overly lengthy explanation. You don't need to do any of that. Simple reframe. He must have a thing for cute Midwestern girls as well. Easy. But no, Rhaegar is mine. Ha ha. He was definitely using whatever moves he could. Oh, Rhaegar, like Game of Thrones. Yes, you're a fan, so a little bit of banter and back and forth. Well, of course, I've watched it like 4 times. Perfect. We can nerd out together while dogs play. So this is the soft close. So you can see this chick is responding. This is a cold approach number, right? Like, I already trust the fact that I did most of the work in real life. So really all I do is some callback humor, get the conversation started again, get the vibe going, and then smoothly transition towards the meetup. You don't have to text her back and forth for ages. In fact, that's also probably going to work against you. Once you get something going, then just smoothly transition towards the meetup. She says, my favorite, I go for the standard wine close. Do you like wine? I'm no wine connoisseur, but yeah, I enjoyed. It's okay. We should split a ball sometime soon. Haha, sounds good. Here we just have literally logistics. And again, you can find more information about this in the 5 steps to setting up a date video. So here we set up the date, then confirming with a Ryan Gosling meme. Now, full disclosure, I did not meet up with this girl simply because I was personally too busy. But if I wanted to, I easily could have. So there you go. That's how you do it. All right, hopefully you guys found this video valuable. Please show us some of that love by smashing the like button, hit subscribe, and click the bell for notification. Help us get to 100,000 subs. We're almost there, and we can do it with your guys' help. Also, let me know in the comments below what kind of content you guys want to see more of. We're always looking for good suggestions. We have an awesome collaboration coming very soon with TripAdvice. We got a lot of cool interviews, so definitely make sure you stay tuned. Thank you guys for watching, and until next time.